Brokerage account terminologies. In this video, we'll discuss some of the many terminologies used in brokerage accounts, such as market value, account value, unsettled cash, settled cash, cash balance, buying power, pre-market, aftermarket, and good faith violation. Sean G. Academy, nurture your investment and educational appetite. Market value. Market value is the current value of all the stocks in your brokerage account and does not include the value of cash in your account. For example, let's say you have two stocks in your account. Stock A, 10 shares at $5 per share, and stock B, 15 shares at $8 per share. Then the market value of stock A would be 10 times 5, which equals $50, and the market value of stock B would be 15 times 8, equals $120. Then the market value of your account would be equal to $50 plus $120 for a value of $170. And this is regardless of how much cash you have in your account. It's also important to note that market value is also referred to as portfolio value. Account value. Account value is the sum of the market value and the cash in your account. So it's the value of all the stocks and all the cash in your account. For example, if you have a market value of $170 and you have a cash balance of $100, then your account value would be $170 plus $100 for a total of $270. It's important to note that the cash balance used to determine the account value does not include any pending transfer funds. Now to unsettled and settled cash. Unsettled cash are restricted funds that is tied to the previous sale of a stock. Whenever you sell a stock, it takes 2 trading days for the transaction to finalize. During that period from the time of the sale before the transaction is finalized is known as the settlement period and is referred to as T plus 2, the day of the transaction plus 2 trading days. And during that settlement period, the funds from that transaction is termed as unsettled funds or unsettled cash. Now, settled cash. Settled cash are unrestricted funds, funds that are not tied to the previous sale of any stock and is not in any settlement period. Let's look at an example of settled and unsettled cash. Let's look at 5 days in the trading week, assuming none of these days are holidays. Let's say you sold a stock on Tuesday. That'll be the trade day, T day, or the transaction day. From the point of sale on Tuesday, the funds from that sale would be unsettled funds. And also on Wednesday, T plus 1 day, the funds will continue to be unsettled funds. And that period would be called the settlement period, and the funds would be considered unsettled funds. On Thursday, T plus 2 day, the transaction would be finalized and the funds would be considered settled. Now, a few things to be noted about unsettled funds. Unsettled funds cannot be transferred out of your brokerage account until they are settled. Also, you can use unsettled funds to purchase stocks, but you cannot sell those stocks purchased with unsettled funds until those funds are settled. For example, say on Monday, you sold stock ABC for $2,000, so Monday becomes T-Day. Then on Monday, you bought stock XYZ for $1,500 using the unsettled funds from the sale of stock ABC. So Tuesday will become T plus 1 and Wednesday will be T plus 2. You cannot sell stock XYZ until the funds from the sale are settled on Wednesday, T plus 2. However, if you do try to sell stock XYZ before the funds are settled, then you will be hit with what is called a good faith violation. A good faith violation occurs when you try to sell a stock that was purchased with unsettled funds before those funds become settled. Each brokerage firm handles good faith violations differently, so you will have to check with your brokerage firm to see how they handle good faith violations. Now, cash balance and buying power. Cash balance is also referred to as brokerage cash or available cash, and it's the sum of the settled funds and the unsettled funds in your account, and it does not include any pending transfer funds. while buying power, which is the funds available to purchase stocks, is also the sum of the settled funds and unsettled funds in your account, but it can also include pending transfer funds. It doesn't always include these funds, but sometimes they do. So if there's no transfer of funds pending, the cash balance and the buying power will always be the same. Now, pre-market and aftermarket. But before we understand what pre-market and aftermarket are, we have to understand what are the market hours. The market hours are the normal trading hours from Monday to Friday, not including holidays, from 9:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Now, the pre-market is the trading period before the normal market hour starts, and that's 4 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. While the aftermarket is the trading period after the normal market hours end, and that's 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. Not all brokerage firms allow you to trade for the full periods of the pre-market and aftermarket, so you can check with your brokerage firm to find out if there's any restrictions for trading during the pre- and aftermarket periods. So if this video was helpful to you, please click the thumbs up button below, and for more educational content and tutorials like this, be sure to subscribe. You could also click the bell to get notified when new contents are posted.